Back to Urban Today. My name is Mubarak Mugabo. You can join the conversation on our social media platforms at Urban TV Uganda on Twitter, on Facebook, Urban Television, on our Twitter handles at Mubarak UG, also at Lynn UG3. Remember, we are talking politics. We are talking elections. 2021 is around the corner. And of course, we want to find out people crossing from different parties to other parties, other crossing from the ruling to the opposition, others from the opposition to the ruling. What exactly is in there? And of course, we want to find out what is between the lines. Now, we can talk a lot about what is happening within parties, but we want to find out how will this election look like, especially given its scientific mode. Now, joining me in studio to discuss all that is Donald Elvis Wasake, data analyst. We want to find out his views and, of course, his findings on the research he has recently conducted. We want to find out how is this election going to look like. Wasake, a very good morning and welcome to Urban Today.
Yes, good morning to you.
Let's go straight to the point. How do you see these scientific elections and what should Ugandans expect out of them?
Mubarak, thank you very much. Good morning. Good morning to all of you who are watching us at home. What I can assure everybody is that this is going to be the most exciting election this country is going to see. The last time this amount of excitement was there was probably 1980, uh-huh, when UPM and UPC and DP were contesting, because of the amount of thrills, the phenomenal, and the pendulum being able to swing in any direction in this election here. So what I can assure people at home and to you, Mubarak, who is analyzing this, is that expect the unexpected.
When you see people crisscrossing from different parties,
yes,
you know, we saw, you know, the Lord Mayor crossing to the FDC, then you have artists and other members of parliament crossing to Bobby Wine's parties. What are we likely to see in these elections? What is so special about these elections? Because we have not been seeing so much of crisscrossing, just like we are seeing now.
Well, the roosters are coming home to rest, finally. When you see the Lord Mayor, artists going from one place to another, this is a clear indicator of the volatility of the election. This election here is at high boiling point because the stakes are too high in every single camp. And apart from the stakes being high, there is a lot which is coming into play, and every single political party, apart from maybe one or two, have a trick up their sleeves. Yes, that is why you see the volatility is high. NUP is highly charged. NRM is doing everything to retain what it's going through. DP is being wounded a little bit here and there.
They are limping somehow.
Well, I would consider.
They are limping, but they are still there.
Yes, they are still there.
They have lived, they are time tested.
Big time. And so on and so forth. But I can tell you it's at high boiling point for every political party.
Looking at the nature of it, the nature of the election that we are going to have, you know, we are likely to miss out on campaigns, the trails, you know, but, you know, how, you know, what are we likely to see? Because what we are experiencing now is door to door. We're seeing people going door to door. Isn't this going to be too much expensive in terms of campaign financing?
Yes. Traditional campaigns are normally expensive. When I started, I said a scientific election offers the best opportunity for a newcomer. Actually, anybody who is standing for office for the first time, who is working on lean budgets and is tech savvy and knows data, this election is going to favor them so much. Yes.
It is going to be cheaper.
It's going to be more efficient. It's going to be more effective for a person who is just starting out, if they understand the science of the election and the data which comes with it.
I'm failing to understand
you
that.
Are,
with
really?
You. Because I'm imagining door-to-door could be more expensive than actually the usual rallies that we always have.
If you choose to do that, if you choose to go door-to-door, if you choose to be mobile out there, but there are very many other smarter ways to actually get into this election and win it.
Like?
Number one, if you can understand your voter register to the full detail, that means you can analyze those demographics there without necessarily going into the field and go knocking door to door. If I knew Village X has 60 people, of these 60, 40 are youths who are unemployed, 20 are women in circles. That means my message is already coined. I know what I'm saying before I even go to the field. That's number one. Number two, if I had everybody's contact address, Mubarak, that is a game changer.
Really?
Yes. How? You're at home I'm candidate Donald Wasake. Mm-hmm. I can reach you anytime, anywhere. You have understood that?
Yes.
I can call you. I can SMS you. I can send you mail. I can WhatsApp you.
But these registers have been in existence.
The registers are in existence. Mm. That's why I said a person who understands the data of the election and the science is the one who's going to take the day. Yes, the registers have been there in existence. It's public knowledge. Okay? But very few candidates, I can assure you, go into the detail of analyzing the register and matching it with its contacts.
Yes.
The contacts are the game changer here. Right
the contacts are the game changers. Yes. But when you look at what exactly the different analysts were talking about in the beginning, they were saying that this election mostly favors the incumbents.
Because they don't understand.
They are already established.
Yes.
Yes, just like, not like these newcomers. Mm. I'm wondering, well, actually, your explanation is a little bit different.
Well, because they're thinking about it from a traditional sense of the election of go out to radio, go out to TV, spend big budgets. Donald Wasake, your candidate, is on Urban TV right now.
Yes.
He's paying big budgets.
Mm-hmm.
There is a plot to the twist. Okay? There's a very big plot here.
Mm-hmm.
If I am running in my constituency and I know my entire electorate are 100,000 people,
yes,
and I can match it with 100,000 phone numbers, I'm in those people's homes.
When you look at the environment that we are in now, you earlier said that NUP is charged, then NRM is really,
yes,
you know, the game is really up there.
Yeah.
What are the driving factors that you're seeing that are going to make people win this election?
Passion driven and what I would call ebirungi biri mu maso. A movement that is driven by the future. It's not driven by gain right now. That is a movement that is not being even paid. That is what you're seeing in NUP. Their foot soldiers are charged. Mm-hmm. Their foot soldiers are passionate. Their foot soldiers are not being paid. The only other time, from my analysis of all elections, that has been seen was 2006, 2001 with Kano Kizza Besigye.
Mm-hmm.
And the most prominent I can relate it to is 1980. And during that entire Bushwa struggle of the president, he was using kadogos,
yes,
child soldiers.
People who do not have a lot to lose.
A lot to lose. And they are dedicated themselves. Even the ones who were in the lead, the leads, the generals, the so on. These people were graduates who left campus and were not being paid a single coin, but it was their passion.
And sacrifice.
And exactly, which was fueling them. That is a movement you don't mess around with. And that is what I'm seeing in NUP. The trends are similar. There are very many similarities of UPM of 1980
to the NUP of
now. NUP right now. Yes.
Does the NRM have capacity to stop this? Because UPC, we know, lost
the NUP
of that time.
Actually, I keep telling people that right now, NUP has taken the color red. UPC has been usurped. Because when you see red, you see people power.
Yes.
You don't see UPC anymore. Jimmy Akene is having his battles with his people.
Yeah.
Right now, his house is not in order.
Yes.
We all know that.
Yeah.
Red equals
he has two different factions.
Exactly.
He has failed to put together.
Exactly.
Mm.
So NRM definitely is in power right now.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to pull every single thing that they would do, even if you're in power, even if I was in power.
You would, of course, do. Yes, exactly.
This is their election to lose,
mm,
but it's going to be a slippery one. Very slippery indeed.
Slippery in which nature? Because when you look at the difference between the winner and the loser is going to be very, very small. And looking at the factor of the state machinery,
yes,
I'm wondering whether actually the movement you're talking about, because the movement of the 80s took up guns and defeated the state machinery.
Yes.
I'm wondering whether these actually have the capacity.
I really think they do.
To maneuver.
I think they have the capacity to do quite a number of things. Number one, they are having ideological fighting. Once ideology is transformed, that is the biggest weapon for any war. That means people are in come and buy and buy.
Yes.
We go, we go.
Yes.
That is number one that these people have managed to do. Number two, once people are charged, the only thing missing is the light to blow up this gasoline here. That is all I can say.
What I want to understand is that what does the ground suggest? And, you know, because we have not looked at the recent, opinion polls.
Yes.
what does the ground read? Like, you know, are we looking at, are we seeing Yoweri Museveni still in the lead? Then, you know, between Chiza Besigye and Bobi Wine.
Yes.
What exactly is the ground reading?
From the polls that we're about to release in about a week's time, the president is still in the lead. I think you can see in some publications, the president is still in the lead. That one is very true. But his margin has become slimmer. From my analysis, I can tell you that the margin of the president is going to reach a maximum of 60%. He cannot cross 60%. And this is scientifically speaking, and this is my data and years of research to represent the demographic changes right now. It's not going to go beyond that. And you can mark my word on this.
So what you're saying is that he can as well drop, but he cannot go beyond 60%.
He can't go beyond 60%.
What informs that?
What informs that is the pulse of the demographics right now, the voting patterns and the electorate, the prospective electorate. Voter turnout, by the surprisingly, is going to be higher. Even if all the things that people may say, disenfranchisement, people are not going to come, people are going to turn out this election here because there are quite a number of reasons for them to do so.
And these reasons are?
Number one, the number of people who registered for national IDs is the same number of people who are captured on the Electoral Commission databases now. If you have for a national ID, you are on the Electoral Commission database eligible to vote. That's reason.
Whether you registered for elections or not.
Or not. You are on the database.
Yes.
Already many people did not want to go through the hassle of going to line up to get to try and register for voting. But now, national ID equates to
being a voter's register.
Exactly.
A voter's card, rather.
That is already 50% in. Okay.
Yes.
Already 50% in.
Yes.
Number two, there is a certain demographic of people who have been ignored for quite a while. Okay, starting from the last election, the youths who were 16 years old did not vote in 2016.
Exactly. They are now over 18.
Exactly. Their right of passage has come. Their right of passage has
come. And they don't want to know what exactly the country has gone through.
Exactly. They don't know these things here. They don't relate to the 35-year regime of the president, even if it has been good, but they can't relate to it. They are cliff-hanging. They are looking for anything which they can call home.
And that's why they are so much close, attached
exactly.
to Bobi Wine and all that.
They're attached to Bobi Wine.
What does the ground read between Bobi Wine and Chiza Besigye? Because we see Chiza Besigye's card seems to be exhausted. But
I don't think so, Mr. Mubarak. I think you will chew those words there.
Yeah?
I think you really chew those words there. What people may anticipate is that FDC may be losing strength. I strongly disagree, and the data disagrees too. FDC has very strong grassroots structures, only second to NRM.
Really?
Only second to NRM.
Where does he stand in your data? Like Chiza Besigye as a person,
yes.
as a candidate,
yes.
assuming he's a candidate in the next election.
I would still put him at number two, ahead of Bobi Wine.
What's like, where do you stay?
I stay in Kampala, but the data talks. No. I am the one here telling people that a scientific election favors a new B. Favors a person with new money. I mean, because it's the truth. Numbers don't lie, Mr. Mubarak. Numbers don't lie.
Really?
Every village
so what
in
we
this
are
country
is,
here
has an FDC.
Has at least 15 FDC people, while NRM has at least 30. These are all ground troops.
So you want to suggest that Bobi Wine and his group are only in Kampala here and in the central region?
No. Actually, from our analysis, the biggest inroads NUP has made is in northern Uganda.
Really?
The penetration rate of NUP is highest in northern Uganda, starting with central,
yes,
northern, western, and then eastern.
Yes.
Yes. The penetration rates are much higher. For northern Uganda, it's also something to do with the color, with the party color. Red is traditionally their color as you
yes,
see danger.
Yes.
Bobi Wine has usurped that.
Yes.
The penetration rate is higher. And to prove that, indeed, I want you to take a simple poll, which is unbiased. If you see a party with flag bearers in LC1, councillors, the lowest levels of the election.
Of the administrative units.
Exactly. Those are ground troops. Those are ground troops who are doing all the donkey work. You can't.
So meaning that Bobi Wine is actually Kizza Besigye is still a very potential candidate for the FDC.
No other words have been truthfully said this morning here. Yes, he is still the biggest contender against President.
We had reports of suggesting that Lukwago could be blessed.
I would wish Mr. Lukwago the best of luck. I haven't done any of his polling, but preliminary, he does not enjoy.
He doesn't cross Chira.
Exactly. He doesn't enjoy the national appeal.
But what gives Museveni this prominence? Because for us, we think, some of us who are, you know, driving around the streets of Kampala and indeed in these other new cities,
yes,
we don't feel Yoweri Museveni.
Because your expectations are high, always. You want more, they give you more. Mm. You want more, you keep wanting more. You're like a never-ending slay king or slay queen. You keep wanting more.
The ones who are staying in Nigeria. And
yes, you keep wanting more. Mm. You keep wanting more.
But then, where does this leave the traditional parties, UPC and DP?
Let me start with DP. DP started off the year very promising. Mm-hmm. The DP block, the recruitments, the reunion, everything was going perfect. Somewhere along the way, one thing did not work out or the other, and it has proved to be a huge gasoline backlash. The blow-up is very big. Mm. I think in this whole process, the party that is limping the most is DP. The crossovers, mm-hmm. the infiltrations.
Yes.
There are so many things that DP has gone through, which it's continuing to go through. I think DP is going to lose, is going to be the most hit party in parliament. Their parliamentary seats
because
are going to drop.
Because they have about 15. Yes.
Exactly. Apparently. Those 15 seats are going to drop. I could be wrong. You know, sometimes the data is wrong. Mm. But the
it's
likely
not,
indicators.
Going to be so much.
Yes.
You know,
the likely indicators. The DP is on the losing end. UPC, even the little power it had consolidated in the north, I said, people power has infiltrated it.
Where is the Alliance for National Transformation?
I like the Alliance for National Transformation because its leader, Mugisha Muntu, Mr. Gregory, puts out a good image, the aura. Mm. Unfortunately for him, and now let me put this on national TV.
He's good as an archbishop. I have heard that from different politicians. He said, good cardinal.
He is seated on the fence of political history. Seated on the fence. He's within and without.
Yes.
This is a battle line of you're either with us or against us. You can't be witwashy, lovey-dovey, razzle-dazzle. No.
That's why Kizza Besigye is saying, that's why Power was saying, if you're not for defiance.
Exactly. Out. And by the way, people keep forgetting, they say Kizza Besigye is angry, the defiance, but that defiance is represented by about 3.5 billion people who voted him last time.
Yes.
That means defiance and anger is represented. People want to hear that. People want to hear a consistent
that's
message.
Why when you see, this is what Bobi Wine is trying to imitate.
Yes.
When you see Bobi Wine speaking,
yes,
you see that kind of anger.
He has
which
stepped
is actually,
it up.
Which is not like natural. It is
exactly.
Kind of artificial anger.
Even if it's artificial or natural,
but
Kizza Besigye well played.
But some of them saying that this anger plays to his disadvantage.
No.
Some people fear to vote for him.
No.
To vote for him.
Those are the people who have decided not to vote for him because they have never related to that personality.
You don't like somebody. Fair to Kizza Besigye.
I'm fair to the numbers. I am fair to the numbers and to what I see on ground. Because as an analyst, the numbers don't lie. The numbers don't lie.
So how are we likely to see Parliament, the 11th Parliament?
The 11th Parliament is actually going to be quite interesting. Higher number.
What will be the composition of it?
Higher numbers of independents. Now, with the 523 new constituencies now, which is a ruse for the NRM, one way or the other. Mm. But this is what I see. The number of new entrants into Parliament is the status quo is going to be maintained because last parliament you have about 65%
absolutely
new entrants.
Yes,
that's why the demographics of Uganda are quite interesting because incumbency rates in other countries is high,
but here it's really
it is swinging.
It's every actually
exactly.
term that comes and passes.
Exactly. Mm. And 2016 was the most dominant. I expect that status quo to continue. Mm-hmm. Even the new ones who won their one term are fighting for their lives.
Unfortunately, actually, we may not have enough time here, but of course, we shall come back with you on Crossfire and discuss these analysis, because I'm sure there are so many people who are not happy with the findings, especially those ones who are so much optimistic about the NRM and the People Power and DP and all that. But in your final remarks, how are we seeing this the outcome of the 2021 elections? Are we seeing the status quo, you know, remaining, or we are seeing a change? You know, if all goes well,
if the election was held today, today as of today, we're on air, the status quo would remain.
The status quo would remain.
The president would win the election.
Mm-hmm.
He would have a sweep in parliament, and People Power would be another idea flirting within people's minds.
Are you seeing them making the next shadow cabinet?
Yes, partly. They are going to share it. They are going to share the spoils of political war.
Like in parliament, you're likely to see forces of FDC and then NUP, forming, you know.
Yes.
So the ones who, the margin may not be as big as, you know, it has been with FDC and DP. Because it's remember, FDC had about 35, then DP had about 15.
FDC, I don't see the number of FDC MPs reducing. Surprisingly, by the way.
Really?
It's either going to remain
mm-hmm.
or it's going to slightly climb. The biggest winner in all of this is going to be NUP. The biggest loser is going to be DP.
The biggest loser is going to be DP. But hey, DP has been here for quite some time. That's according to analyst Donald Elvis Wasake. But of course, we shall have more discussions with him on Crossfire 2. You know, that was on Saturday at, 9 a.m. And of course, we'll be here with Paul Rushalizi and, of course, other political analysts trying to discuss all this. Now, you know, Urban Today, of course, takes a short break. When we return, we have lots and lots. We have Seguya and, of course, Becky Cynthia Nachimera. That is politics. We're now turning to other stuff. Urban Today returns in a short while.